says, bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and don't forget any of his benefits. Hallelujah. Redeeming your life from destruction, he's crowned us with his loving kindness and tender mercies. How many are thankful? Hallelujah. Father, we thank you today for all of your loving kindness and your mercies toward us. We thank you, Father, for Jesus, our Savior, gave us life that we might have life. Today, Father God, we gather together in Jesus' name to worship, to praise, and to declare all of your goodness in our lives. We thank you for every good and every perfect gift. Hallelujah. For you are the Father of light. There is no variableness, not a shadow of turning. We thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
To be answered.
praise team. Thank you for all that is in the presence of the Lord today. And of course, today being Men's Day, the men of honor are going to be in charge today. So we pray that as we present our best to you today, that you would please bear with us. And also, we just want to say, did you see your brother Ethan? God bless you. Thank you, Brother Walter and Brother Simon. All right, we're going to hold them out. We're going to get them trained a little bit more. We're going to have them out. So it's a great honor, a great privilege today for us to celebrate today with you, the men of honor. Before we get started, today is Veterans Day, and so I just want to honor all our veterans that have served for our country in time of peace and time of war. Well, all of our veterans, please stand up. This next gentleman that I'm going to be bringing up, he's going to be our Master of Ceremonies. And just to tell you a little bit about this gentleman, I haven't known him long, but what I've grown to know about him, I've come to love. He has a heart of compassion. He loves souls. He loves people. And he's always trying to figure out what he can do to help. I remember 2 weeks ago he came, or maybe last week, 2 weeks ago, he came back to the back where I was doing the sound, and he said, "Brother Derek, if I can come back here with you to help you to learn what to do, because I'm interested." And so he's always trying to find out where he can help. And when it came to Masters of Ceremonies this week, he volunteered. And so we're so grateful. Without further ado, stand to your feet as we bring our Masters of Ceremonies to you. None other than our own Mr. Frank, Brother Frank Butler.
Well, we got off to a good start so far, and I want you to know that the theme that we have this for the Men's Day is soul winning. And when I think of soul winning, you know, I think a lot about my own soul and how I came to know the Lord. And a little bit of that is that I think about how one person, if me say, and I go and talk to someone else and get them saved. When I think about the ripple effect of soul winning, my grandmother, who was just one generation out of slavery, was the person that really, I would have to say, was the most instrumental in saving myself. She introduced me to the Lord at an early age. She took me everywhere she went. She was a great warrior for the Lord, a great prayer warrior. And so I think about her, and I want to just take a second, and you all think about the person that really got you involved. Think about the person that saved your soul. And then think about who you have presented the Lord to. Think about that person. And then that person that's presented the Lord to someone else. So when I think about soul winning, the verse that comes to mind the most to me, I guess, is John 3:16. "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever shall believe in him will have everlasting life." Well, you know the action word in that whole thing is believe. And there is so much in the word believe. You know, we oftentimes think that believe is just something that we do up here. But believe me, believe is an action word all the way. And when we're thinking of going out and talking to people about the Lord, when we're talking about going out and saving souls, the one thing that I think that comes to mind, Pastor Williams was saying something this morning about when he was young, he was into jazz. Well, I think of a song that I used to sing a lot when I was young. And it was Show and Tell. When I think of winning souls, I think of that song, Show and Tell. Because, you know, a lot of times people think that you go out and you tell people about Christ, but a lot of it is what they see in you. What you do and how your life goes is a lot in what they will end up in. So the show part of it is how you run your life. And then you can get really involved in the tell part then, because when they see how you present, how you conduct your life, and then they want to come to you and say, you know, I like you, it's something about you. And that's when the tell part comes. So, you know, our pastor talks to us a lot about also being prepared. When they do come to you, we have to have that knowledge, and we have to be able to answer some hard questions sometimes, because sometimes people are they can be pretty tricky when it comes to soul saving, and so we have to be prepared, and that's where when our pastor tells us, come to Bible study, come to Sunday school, we got to do some more things besides just being a bench member in church. Bench member in church is pretty good. It gets you some things, but it's a week-to-week thing. And so, you know, going week-to-week, sometimes you forget in that week period. But when you can, when you've got a pastor who's willing, willing to be here during the week for you, and willing to open these doors on Tuesdays and Thursday mornings, when we got that, we have to take advantage of it ourselves. Don't just let it be in vain. Don't let his work be in vain. He's trying to help us as much as we can, so we have got to help him.
Amen.
So thank you, Pat. You know, we were talking also earlier about veterans, and this, I'm a veteran myself, but I just want to say there is a program that veterans have that's called Soul Saving. And one of the things we talk about in that program is don't always feel like the person whose soul you're trying to save is going to come to your church. Sometimes they may go somewhere else, but the key is saving that soul. So we want to save souls. Now, we got a little surprise for you. We have, you know, when I was young, my parents got me involved. My mother, grandmother got me involved in church early. And so we have some little men in this church, some young men, I should say. And we didn't get to practice this week, so you guys bear with us and kind of follow along. But we have a little icebreaker. We have Darrell, if you'll come up. Justice, Daxton, and Jayton and Daxton. You know, another part of soul winning is, I'm from Kansas City and we used to ride the bus a lot. And on the bus, you would see young men on the bus and they would, and you would hear things like, excuse me, please, I'm sorry, thank you. You know, soul winning is a lot of things. And so when you see a young man who is willing to say thank you, who's willing to open the door for a lady, who's willing to make sure that someone gets home safely or whatever, when you see that home training come out in them, then you know that somewhere somebody has been telling him about the Lord. So we're proud to have some young men in our church who I believe have that quality. So what we're going to do is just a little icebreaker, we'll call it. Which one's going to speak first? Yeah, okay. You guys, if you just follow along with us.
Amen.
As I said, we didn't have a lot of practice, but we're going to do the best we can.
Amen.
We need a couple of microphones, I think. Yeah, I know I've been watching Michael Jackson. He didn't want to give up the microphone.
Please stand.
What he said was, when we point our mics at you, we want you to say, Jesus, Jesus, okay? So we hope that we get a good response from this. Are you guys ready? Ready, drummer?
1, 2, 3.
Hey there, wait a minute, put a little Jesus in it. Shout it loud enough, as Brother Williams say, for Timothy to hear us. He's not that important to us. Okay? One more time.
Y'all ready?
Ready. Hey, wait a minute. Put a little Jesus in it.